My budget solar panel trailer, 400 watt solar panels from Harbor Freight, 100 watts each. The trailer is 4 foot by 6 foot. Panels are approximately 2 foot by 3 foot, 100 watts each, of course. I wanted budget friendly connections. This is a heavy duty extension cord. We use these at work. This one got cut, so now it's part of my solar trailer. I can just pull this to disconnect the trailer from the batteries. So we have the charge controller. This shows what the solar panels are charging. We're at 12.9 volts. Battery's connected. And then this turns on this. So the four panels come in to a little bus bar collector. Collector goes through a 25 amp fuse. 25 amp fuse. 400 watts. Probably never hit 400 watts, probably. Just in case there's the fuse that'll cut it off. Then the charge controller monitors the battery voltage. Tells you when it's charging, and then this turns on your source, your load. USB ports, which I don't really care about here. Again, this is output to the batteries, and then the solid state relay. This will be a connection later to do something else for my power output. What this does is, these are 10 amp outputs. This is a 40 amp relay. This just turns on that relay. It automatically cycles off at 11.5 volts and then will turn off the relay. Right now, not in use. Then this will get a little door over it so that weather doesn't get into it. From the solar trailer into the batteries. The batteries are inside this tote. Two 12 volt batteries. These are deep cycle marine batteries. Wired in parallel. Negative, negative, positive, positive. This is coming from the charge controller on the trailer. So it's sensing this battery voltage and turning the solar panels on and off, maintaining charge on the batteries. So this charge controller, solid state relay, and power inverter. We have a shared ground. The charge controller here, again, this would be solar panels in, but we merely want to sense the voltage. Then this is 10 amps out. So, not real sure what you're going to do with just 10 amps. So, this turns that on and off. The 10 amps goes onto this. It doesn't need 10 amps. It's milliamps to turn on this solid state relay. If you see the little light come on. Then you have power from the battery itself. This is a 25 amp fuse, which goes to the inverter. The inverter is a 300 watt inverter. 12 volts inverter, 120 volts. So these are like $69 to $150 deep cycle marine batteries. Inverter 300 watt, that's like $15-$20. These are like $10. Get a standard car fuse here, and this charge controller is like $12. I have 350 watt LED lights plugged into this power inverter.